right, and then right here at the bottom, y'all can see, hey, the last 10 years of some of the descent rates. So basically what we're trying to show you, like the fatalities and everything like that, most of the times, those were whenever they're in like a turn or they're in some kind of like spin or something like that. So if you're able to get low and slow and actually do a good descent checklist, or excuse me, a good ejection. All right, so man, why are you so special? What's up with all the cameras and stuff?
I'm going to compete for Miss America in 3 weeks, and so we're doing joint public affairs with the Air Force and Miss America.
Did you win at a state level?
Yes, I'm Miss Colorado right now.
Miss Colorado, yeah. Terrific.
So, trying to make it a positive thing for the Air Force, for everyone.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
You're being very modest.
So these clips right here?
Yeah, we just have to...
Let me take the helmet off real fast.
So
you have 50 rewrites like that, pull down to your chest, look away, and then release. And then if you need to do the front riser, then bring it around. There you go. Pull down to your chest, look away, and then release. All right, you've untwisted it. Now you have a good parachute.
Okay.
So after canopy, what's next?
Visor,
lift that up. Yep, after then mask. So you're going to pull the mask off. All right, and then reminder, you would have this contour to be stitched in to the webbing.
Okay.
All right, and so you're going to have to, when I say usage wise, you have to pull once to probably break the stitching, and then pull again all the way down to break the core. There you go. So all the way down, so now you can steer.
Okay.
Right, you know, like you turn left, you know, or pull left, you turn left, and then you're looking for a good place to land.
Okay.
You know, if you shoot in,
you can let go of it. They'll come out.
Is he one of the...
Oh,
you want
that? Yeah.
All right. You can just leave the helmet there.
Like this, and I'm facing this way.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, I did that with my
head again. All right. And then. That was it. You're good.
Alright, so first thing, let's get you into a flight suit. We can't fly on our OCPs, it just doesn't work with the gear that we have.
Okay.
So we're going to get you into a flight suit. I have a few here already. That one's also another good one.
That's probably the most closest one.
You think so?
The first one
was really good.
First one, you think so?
All right. Yeah, let's
try both of them.
Okay.
Yeah, let's try both of those.
Okay.
So...
Your cranium.
If you want to take a seat here, okay. We're going to do some measurements to fit you to a helmet. Make sure you get in the right size helmet.
And then for tomorrow, hair-wise...
Yep, so hair is a low...
Okay, do you want me to take this out?
It will help for whenever we're putting the helmet on for you. Alright, so the first measurement is going to be the width of your head.
Okay.
He's going to place these on your temples. Just let him know whenever it touches your temple, and then we'll stop with the measurement and then take the measurement from there.
Touching? My ears are folded
down. Are they? Yeah, so you can pull apart.
Okay. Yep.
And then they should slot into the earpieces. If not, they might be touching a little bit. That's okay. But it should be a somewhat comfy fit. Perfect. All right.
Feels like it's...
So a little bit further back. Perfect, right there.
Here? Okay. Yeah.
Perfect. All right, yep. So that's inside.
All right, you can take it off.
Okay.
All right, you pull that off. It's a pull the dot. Just pop.
Hold on. Just down?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Go. Don't want to break anything.
Well, whatever you break, we could fix.
I had trouble with this during the parachute training. Okay, there we go.
Perfect. Yep, so just, you're in the right spot, just angle it more towards you. Perfect. Yep. Are you able to breathe just fine? No, are the bayonets digging into your cheeks at all? Nothing feels uncomfortable yet?
Is this chin strap?
Yeah, if you want to, on the right side, pop, take off your mask on the right side real quick.
It was like this was, oh wait.
Okay.
Is it supposed to be here or is it supposed to be like this?
The first way you had it.
Okay. I just wanted to double check.
Yep. Are you okay? I promise you, you're, yep. So.
Oh wait, I can't breathe.
So it's really weird feeling. It is supplying you oxygen. I promise you. It's just forcing it into your lungs. So.
My ears are equalizing. Is that normal as well?
Yes.
Because whenever it's pushing in, I'm like feeling it out of my ear.
So you're still having a leak on the top there.
Not as uncomfortable once I chill out.
Yeah. It's super weird at first, huh?
Yeah.
There's actually like a rhythm to the machine. So once you figure out the rhythm, you'll notice that it's going to shoot a lot of air at you. And then if you shoot air back at it, it'll calm down and let you exhale. So. But it is so weird. It threw me off
today.
My first time. All right, so now I know you're not comfortable, but are you okay right now? All right, so what I'm gonna have you do is I'm gonna have you take a deep breath. I'm gonna have you hold it. Don't let any air out. All right, now you can exhale. Perfect. Really good job.
And nobody asked
you
for steps in the
guy. What you just said is if you fly an S-18, well, yeah.
That's what he said. He said if you
fly
a Viper,
you know there's like Viper and Falcon. They call them the different. That's
gonna be. Yeah, if you want to start off the button, that will help keep it together.
Viper,
and then do that.
Perfect.
Alright. So now where you want it to sit is you want it to not sit over your rib cage because that's going to crush your rib cage.
Oh, okay.
Over that. So you want it to be just under your rib cage.
Okay.
Perfect. Yep, just under your rib cage. All right, when the G-suit's fully inflated, you want it to not crush any of your limbs. So we're going to make sure that you have it nice and loose. No, because it's going to tighten up a lot whenever it inflates.
Okay.
And if it's already squeezing you before it inflates, it's going to hurt whenever it does inflate.
Okay.
So
it feels like snug now.
Perfect. And you're going to actually sit down with us and we're going to inflate it for you so that way you can get an idea of what it's going to feel like.
Okay.
We'll be pushing a decent amount of air through it so that way we can make sure you make it.
I don't think so. Hopefully.
We'll have you take a seat in this, okay. This chair here and then be all to tell from there.
Bend the knee at 45, not 90.
Yeah, so here. About there.
This feels pretty good.
Feels pretty good. All right, I'll have you scoot closer. What I'll have you do is, without covering the hole, I'm going to have you push down this little black piece.
Okay.
You're going to stand up and you're just going to squat and it's going to let out the air inside the piece.
Okay. Okay, that feels tight now that I'm standing up.
All right.
You have the
screw
too, right?
Just for...
Is this okay?
Yeah.
I can feel it touching my
knuckles. Yes, yep, that was good. And then we'll have you do it again once you have your leg straps on because it'll tighten up around your waist.
Okay.
Perfect.
Oh, wait. Is it supposed to be underneath this thing?
Yes, but it's fine to be the other way at the moment. Nice. Is it?
Oh.
Okay. I'll have you undo the legs.
Okay.
So this piece here is gonna pop out. There you go.
Yep.
Nice. Oh, nice.
All right, he's gonna reach for it real quick and he's gonna untangle it for you because it's something that you have to be able to see to understand where it's tangled at. Yeah, good now. Perfect. All right, let's do that again. And then the hose of your G-suit will slot through the left hand side there, making sure that it's nice. There we go, perfect. Perfect, yeah.
And that's good.
All right. And now I'm going to tug on your shoulders here, make sure that's tight. Perfect. All right.
That's
good. We'll get the excess stowed away for you. I think that's all I should do.
This is the hose that's coming from the jet with oxygen. It connects right down there.